to the iTwin developer session, quick and easy augmented reality with your digital twin. My name is Matt Gooding, and I am a software engineer working on the iTwin platform. In today's session, we are going to start with an overview of tools for creating augmented reality content. We'll follow that up with a discussion of the Mesh Export API that's part of iTwin platform and can be used to create intermediary files from your iModels. And we will finish out the session by talking about creating augmented reality content for the web from your iModel using the Mesh Export API. So if you are interested in creating augmented reality content, you are probably aware that one good option is to use the game engines, Unity or Unreal Engine. We've previously talked about how to connect the iTwin platform to these game engines in two of our development webinars. I did a session on Unity about a year ago, and my colleague Mike Melisong did one on Unreal Engine a few months ago. We will have links to those webinars at the end of this presentation if you haven't seen them already. Another option is to use the native APIs for the mobile platforms, ARKit for iOS or ARCore for Android. These are definitely the most difficult to use option, but also the most power. You are using the hardware as directly as you can. So you will always be able to leverage all of the features that the platform makers have put into their platforms. But these are definitely the most difficult options, and we won't be going into them today. However, the Mesh Export API that I mentioned earlier can be used to create the raw material needed to display your iModel in these APIs. Lastly, you can use some native web platforms for creating augmented reality. There is a developing standard called WebXR that is supported by most web browsers. Unfortunately, it is not supported for iOS. On iOS, there is an option called Quick Look that we'll be talking about a little bit later in the session. But Quick Look isn't supported elsewhere. And lastly, there is a library called Model Viewer that can be used to bridge the gap between these two worlds, and we'll be talking about that later on in the session. Now, unfortunately, all of these tools require mesh geometry as input, but the format of that geometry is really not well standardized. Legacy attempts at interchange 3D formats like FBX, Kavada, and OBJ are poor fits for the web for a variety of reasons. Either they require SDKs that aren't compatible with the web browser, they are slow to load, they're slow to transmit, they have too many options, and the data ends up not coming out consistently. But given these set of parameters, can we do anything except despair? Well, fortunately, there is a solution, and that solution is GLTF. GLTF is an open standard developed by the Kronos group that is optimized for transmission on the web and is supported by really excellent tooling. There's great tooling for checking the validity of your models, that you're spec compliant. There's great tooling for using GLTF in all of the different game engines inside of your web browser and the web 3D libraries, 3JS and Babylon.js. I think they've done everything just about right with this platform. And so given my effusiveness, we have developed a REST API to generate GLTF files from iModels for use in visualization and simulation pipelines. Now, the underlying iTwin.js API export graphics has been the foundation for integrations with game engines and Bentley products for a few years now. But now we have it available as a hosted API in the iTwin platform. You no longer need to run your own Node.js process with the iTwin.js libraries in order to extract simplify mesh data from your iModels. So our goal with this is to provide a simple and standardized basis for integration with visualization and simulation tools that require mesh input, which is a whole lot of things. Meshes are the lingua franca of the geometry world. So with all that said, let's go ahead and try it out. All right, so we can find the information on how to use the Mesh Export API at developer.bentley.com, APIs Mesh Export. Again, there will be a link to this at the end of this presentation. Now, this is a pretty straightforward API. You start an export and specify the iModel and type. At this point, the only valid type is GLTF, along with a variety of options about what kind of geometry you want to get as output. But the most important thing is really just the iModel and the export type. And once that's started, you can check the status of your export, and when it's finished, you will get a URL where you can download the resulting GLTF file. So let's see this in action. We have a sample, again, on developer.bentley.com that shows a simple export for a iModel that we're viewing from the sandbox. So all you do is click export to GLTF that submits the job. We wait for the job to finish. And when it finishes, we will get this, a result URL. We can click download result. We'll save that there. Now we've got our GLTF file in there. Let's actually go ahead and extract that into this directory. All right, great. Now we've got our GLTF and bin file. And I'm actually going to open this nice free demo viewer. I use this for checking a lot of my GLTF files. I'll just drag and drop. And voila, we have the model geometry transferred in GLTF format and able to work in the open GLTF ecosystem. Now, say you have this sample and you want to integrate this into your own iTwin Viewer app. Well, fortunately, that's very straightforward. If you follow our iTwin Viewer tutorials to start building your Viewer app, that will give you the bare bones skeleton that you need. And then you can skip right over the second tutorial and go to the third tutorial on adding showcase widgets to your iTwin Viewer. And you can actually pull the files from this into your own project and add it right into your viewer. So I've done that here, and I have the house sample iModel. So now if I click export to GLTF in here, it behaves exactly like the one from the sandbox. And I can, when this finishes, get a GLTF file that, again, I'll be able to view in. Let's do the same thing. Extract there. Okay. Go back here. Refresh the guy. Pull this up. And again, voila, we have our iModel turned into a GLTF file and ready to participate in the open GLTF ecosystem. Okay, great. Now that we see how to integrate the Mesh Export API with our iTwin Viewer, let's think about the next steps. How do we create augmented reality content from this? So let's survey the options for creating augmented reality content on the web. We might start with WebXR since that's the standard, but unfortunately it's not supported on iOS devices. iOS devices support augmented reality instead via the Quick Look API, but that's not a standard or supported outside of Apple products. Again, can we do anything except despair? Yes, we can. Model Viewer is the solution. Model Viewer is a really nice browser library that provides a simple interface for viewing GLTF in your web browser or in augmented reality, whether that's WebXR or Apple's Quick Look. So let's give this a try with our GLTF file that we made earlier. Now, if we use the full house model, it's not going to work very well for the kind of phone-based AR we're looking at. If we wanted to do something where we were going to line up with an existing structure, we would either want to be geolocated or use some kind of monument point setup that would be more complicated and require using either a game engine or one of the native APIs we talked about earlier. So instead, let's try to pick out a subsection of this model that's kind of object to person size. That's where this kind of quick look model viewer type AR really shines. Now, fortunately, the Mesh Export API supports filtering based on what we see. So for this house model, we can dig in. Let's go to our categories. And yeah, okay. If we're inside of here, eventually. Get under the roof. Okay, good. We can see there's a lot of furniture. That would be perfect for looking at here. Now, let's see. What if we turn everything off? And let's just look for the furniture on the second level. Okay, and what would be good to test? All right, well, let's start hiding things and maybe we'll find something that looks good. All right, we'll hide those. Hide those. Let's hide those too. Yeah, we'll hide that. We'll hide this. We'll hide that. And finally, let's hide that. Perfect. Just what we wanted to look at in augmented reality. All right, now let's go ahead and start our export. All right, we can download. And extract that out. Let's look at it in our GLTF viewer. Perfect, looks great. All right, now we can try it in Model Viewer. Now, Model Viewer is a nice little library, as I've said, and you can use it entirely programmatically. I could reference my GLTF file and follow other documentation to set it up just the way I wanted. But a really nice feature, especially for our demo here, is that it has an editor view. So let's use the editor. Okay, so again, we can just drag and drop our model in. Looks great. But, you know, I think it could be a little bit more stylish looking. Let's try some kind of music hall. Yeah, great. And because we're using GLTF, which are our standard models, we can take advantage of some of the nice GLTF editing packages that Model Viewer has integrated. So let's change our base color to make something a little more classy. How about a golden toilet? That's what we need. It looks a little dull. So let's turn up the metallic factor and decrease the roughness. Great. Now we get some nice reflections on that. Okay. Now, if we wanted to embed this on our site, we could edit this. We could copy this snippet into a page and place the files alongside it, and it would load up just fine. But if I want to preview it in my phone, I can also use this handy deploy mobile feature. So I'll click this. This will bring up a QR code. And now I can go ahead and put my iPhone at that. The link will pop up, and then I will be able to show it in augmented reality. I'll go ahead and show you that now. Now, obviously, that's a small, somewhat silly example, but hopefully it does illustrate just how easy it is to pull out portions of your iModel for use on, in AR or any other visualization platform you might opt for. So to recap, what we learned today is an overview of common technologies for creating AR content, how to use the iTwin platform's Mesh API to create GLTF files, and then how to use the model viewer library with those GLTF files to create quick AR content on the web. Here are some links to relevant APIs and examples that we talked about today. And thank you very much for spending the time with me today. I hope it was beneficial. Please do reach out if you have any questions, comments. I think that what we have with the iTwin platform for doing this kind of work is really nice and simple, and something in my career I've been looking for a long time. If you don't agree, feel free to reach out and let me know that too. Thanks a lot, and appreciate your time.